thing. Real worship doesn't really have anything to do with how melodious your voice is, but it has all to do with how sincere your heart is. Because God will listen to the song of the unrighteous and turn his nose up, but he'll listen to someone who sings in Z flat and A sharp at the same time, and he said, oh, how beautiful the sound of worship. I want you to know the Bible says that God will beautify the meek with salvation. It ain't what you look like or what you sound like, but it's what's on the inside. The Bible says that man looks on the outward appearance, but God looks at the heart. And those of you that know tonight that above all, my heart is clean. I don't hate nobody. I ain't mad at nobody. I've forgiven the folk I need to forgive. I've restored the people I need to restore. I'm in good position now. And in a place like this, ain't no telling what God would do for me now that I have given up and I've allowed him to have his way. Hallelujah to God. Hallelujah. So praise be to God. All right. So I want you to come to church with your mind made up. Hallelujah. We're going to give God great praise because he's worth it. Hallelujah. My hallelujah ain't in the bass guitar. My hallelujah ain't in the drums. It ain't in the organ or the piano. Hallelujah. Look at your neighbor and say, you don't have my hallelujah either. Matter of fact, I got it. Hallelujah. And it's free and I can use it whenever I get ready. So when I think of the goodness of Jesus and all he's done for me, I'm liable to shout at any moment because God's been just that good. You don't know what people go through from day to day. I was sharing with one of the sons earlier. When sometimes when folk come to church, you never know what kind of attitude they're going to have because you don't know what they've gone through from the time they got up. You don't know how many crying babies they heard and how many diapers they had to change and how much rice they burned up and how many times they got cussed out at work and how many times they got cut over on the freeway. You don't know how many promotions they were denied. You don't know how many requests they got no. You don't know what a person had to deal with in the run of a day. But for the simple fact that I made it to the house of God, it says that regardless of what I've gone through, I still got a mind to give him praise. Because if the devil had his way, he would try to discourage me at 8 o'clock and 10 o'clock and 1 o'clock and 3 o'clock and 5 o'clock. But nothing he did today discouraged me, because look at somebody and say, I'm still here. I still came to church. I had reason not to come. I'm tired in my body. Really don't feel like being here. Pastor said, clap my hands. My arms hurt, but I'm going to clap anyway, because we learned how to give him the sacrifice of praise. Because every morning I got brand new mercies, regardless of how Wednesday ends. By the time I wake up in the morning, God going to give me a brand new slate. Now, you know you don't deserve a brand new slate. You know you don't deserve a brand new day. You know you don't deserve another chance, but God is rich in mercy. He is faithful. He is faithful and just to forgive us of all. And who wouldn't holler for a righteous God? Who wouldn't holler for a merciful God? Who wouldn't holler for a deliverance? Who wouldn't holler? And you know what? And he deserves every last one of them. However many times you can sit here and say hallelujah, when you get through, you can say hallelujah from 9 to 9. And when you get through saying hallelujah, it still ain't enough praise. Woo, because somebody said, he done so much for me. Not only can I not tell it all, I can't even praise him for it all. If I had, somebody said, 10,000 tongues, I still couldn't praise him enough. But somebody said, we at least ought to try. Now, why didn't one wash clean me forever? Because here, the only way the one wash is going to clean me forever if I never get out the shower. Oh, but the Bible says we are in the world, but not of the world. And as long as I'm in the world, I'm going to always be vulnerable to the filth and the unrighteousness and the wickedness of the world. So the good thing for us is that when we go out into this wicked world, we got a shower that we can run back to. I might get dirty, but I don't have to stay that way, because the God I serve is a God of forgiveness. He's a God of restoration. How many of y'all know that God is the type of God that'll bring you back again? Some of us have been in, and then we left God. We backslid. We fell away from the faith, but then God brought us back. And then he didn't make us feel bad about being gone. Hallelujah. Remember? And when you have been taught different and the word of God is in your heart, you can't go and do stuff and be all right with it. But you keep on doing it. It's because you got a big old fire extinguisher, and you keep on quenching it. When the Holy Ghost is telling you no, and you say, yes, I am. But we're going after sin. I want you to get your machine guns, your grenades, your bow and arrows, whatever you have. And we got to go after sin. We ain't killing each other. Sin is killing us. I wish I had a church in here on a Wednesday night. You feel like you done fell in the mouth of Jaws and can't get out. I don't even know what it feel like to be in sin and want to get out and can't. It's a sin. It's a stronghold. It's got a hold on your mind. You can't, when you want to think about God, you can't. Sometimes you sit up in church thinking about it. Oh, Lord, please let me not think wickedness in church. That thing that got a hold of your mind. Sin is addictive. That's why the bonds of sin have to be broken. The yoke. And believe it or not, the devil got some of us in a yoke. He got us in a noose. And he's choking us to death with sin. You can't spend Monday through Friday with the devil and come get delivered on Sunday. Mm-mm. You're going to be dancing in bondage.